In my book Schematics 1 Revised that you can buy on the Lulu website, both as an e-book and as a printed book, I've published on page 82 the so-called voltage tripler. At first, it's necessary to say that the energy that we put in here is also available at the secondary side from the transformer, and that means that there is no over unity or whatever. That's completely nonsense. So we even have some loss in that transformer, and you find these circuits often in old school TV sets, and that's why I write here that you can use it with a flyback transformer on 16 kHz. That is more or less the old school frequency that was used in TV sets with a cathode ray tube. And that's of course still the same now, 2017. But this is the circuit, and here we see the circuit with a positive output here. And here we see exactly the same circuit, but now positive is here, and in fact this circuit and this circuit is exactly the same. It's only the question where you connect your earth or ground to. Could be to the positive or to the negative lead. Anyway, when you want to use this circuit on say 16 kHz or 20 kHz or 50 kHz, the transformer must be in resonance. That's very important, because in such a situation the transformer gives its maximum output. And of course, when the circuit works on 10,000 volt, it's very well possible, the diodes here, here and here must be high voltage diodes, and the capacitors here must be able to withstand that extremely high voltage, say 1000 volt or 20,000 volt, etc. So that's important when you build up such a circuit on high voltages. And on high voltages and high currents, the diodes must also be able to make that high current go without burning out. Anyway, this is more or less a hobby circuit, but also in professional equipment you will surely find such a circuit. Here, somewhat panning over things to be taken in account, the maximum voltage for instance, and the maximum voltage that the capacitors can handle. So here we have three capacitors, and also here we have three capacitors, and all these capacitors must be able to handle the maximum voltage that is coming over their electrodes. And that's here, described here. C1, C2, etc. I've used this circuit to supply a cathode ray tube in the past, and I've also used this circuit with electrolytics on a say 150 volts situation. The capacitors have to handle that 150 volts, and this is the reference. Some capacitors that you want to use in that situation must be able to handle a higher voltage. Anyway, You can use this circuit with electrolytics. That's why I've drawn here positive and negative. And also with nonpolar capacitors. And when you use nonpolar capacitors, don't use here resistors, bleeding resistors, because their effect on the resonance from the supply transformer is not so good. So when you have here a supply transformer that gives 16 kilohertz or 20 kilohertz or whatever, when you use here resistors in combination with nonpolar capacitors, the frequency from the oscillator, the frequency from the transformer, will go down. That means that the transformer, that it's possible that the transformer doesn't give out its optimum energy to the circuit. And of course, in that situation, we have here, say, a cathode ray tube with a high internal resistance. That's important. Anyway, a lot to tell about such a simple circuit, and I hope I have given some useful information. The circuit by itself is very good and very well usable.